Recreational is what I always wanted. Could never have too many things. Well, you quit kicking me under the table. I'm trying, will somebody make a shout out about it? Shalom, this is your Ark, Yah is Magnified, coming back with another informative video. I titled this video, Recreational License Reinstated. But before I tackle this subject, as always, I must state for the record, I'm not a lawyer, I do not practice law, and I do not pretend to. All of my videos are for informational and educational purposes only. They're all facts and all truth, nothing more, nothing less. So with that being said, let's get to it. Okay, so now as you all can see, as always, before I do anything, I always provide proof. Okay, if I say somebody got something back, I'm going to either show you proof from the agency or from the court. Or if they say they received something from their job, I'm going to, you know, apply that proof as well. I'm not going to just show you an email stating that someone's saying this happened and that happened and expect y'all to believe it. Okay, I don't do that. But what I do is show y'all actual documents and actual paperwork. Okay. I actually show y'all either from the agency or from the court. Those are the main two I deal with. I don't have nobody jeopardizing their jobs. They're trying to file documents to their jobs that they can end up getting fired or losing their only income they have to provide for their family. I won't do that. Okay? Or unless that's what they want to do. And if they say, okay, I'm ready to go at my job. All right, cool. Let's go at your job then. You made that decision. Let's go at it. Just be ready for the repercussions that can come, that probably can come with it. Okay? That's all I'm stating. But other than that, we'll handle it with the agency. And if the agency don't do what they do, we can either handle it in the court or they can take us to the court and we'll handle it in the court as well. It don't matter how we want to do it. Okay? But the court will be the last option. All right? Keep the controversy out of the public. The court will be the last option unless you are forced to come into it. Then you will go. But other than that, the court is the last option. But let's continue. This is a notice, right, from the recreational license suspension. Then it says, notice of failure to comply with a child support order. Then it says, section 2613126 CRS, right? Then it states, to Colorado Department of Natural Resources, Colorado Division of Parks and Wildlife, okay? Which is letting you know who the agency sent this document to. Then it says, date of notice, 7/19/2018. Okay, so they created the notice on 7/19/2018. My Ogdez probably got this notice, I'd say probably like 5 or 6 days later. If he received it 5 or 6 days later, he probably received it like on the, let's say on the 25th, 26th, like that, you know, of July. But let's continue. As you can see, it's in reference to my Ogdez. I crossed his information out. Dez is the guy who I also did his driver's license suspension for. I didn't know that he sent me this document as well with the driver's license suspension, but I went back over and noticed it, so I'm doing a video about this as well. Okay, so now I crossed out his information. I crossed out his case reference number, his person ID number, customer ID number. Then it says, pursuant to information held at Colorado Division of Child Support Enforcement, State Enforcement Unit, be advised that the above named obligor has failed to comply with a child support order as outlined in section 2613126 CRS. Then it states the obligor's rights of review has been exhausted or the time within which such review may be requested has lapsed. The same thing they told him when before they suspended his driver's license. The same exact thing, that he exhausted all remedies, or that his time for review has been exhausted, so he can't even ask for a review or anything else, you know, talking about the time has lapsed and everything, but he still somehow received his documentation back without paying him a dime, without paying him one red cent, but he get everything back that they claim they are supposed to have been taken from him. But let's continue. It says, therefore, we request you begin the process of suspending the obligor's recreational license pursuant to section 2613126 CRS. Then it states, a copy of this notice has been sent to the obligor at the address reflected on this notice of failure to comply with a child support order. Then it tells you the child support order account number, technician name and a technician phone number. Now, why would they give you the technician name and the technician phone number? Obviously, for you can contact that person. Okay? But, and let's read below that. It tells you exactly what to do. It states, if you have any questions regarding this notice, please contact your child support enforcement technician at the number listed above. Okay? See, what they want you to do is call. Nah, you got the technician name, you got the technician address, respond to him. Send him a correspondence. Hold him accountable. I did a video called Bind the Agent. Why is that? All my videos has been on the same topic all this time. We've been keeping this thing contracts from the beginning. Okay? That's all it's about. Contracts, contracts, contracts. Contract is law. Law is contracts. Okay? The UCC is in direct violation, is in direct harmony with the common law. Okay? Use it. Stop running and use this information. Okay? But let's pick this up where it says note. Note, due to timing issues, if you are suspended and then come into compliance, you may already have missed the deadline to participate in recreational license lotteries. Colorado Division of Child Support Enforcement, State Enforcement Unit, CC Maog Dez. Okay? So that's what they sent Dez. But then, like I told you, they sent it on the 19th, right? Probably took Dez 5 or 6 days to receive it. So he's, let's say he received it on the 25th or 26th. Let's see when they reinstated his information. They reinstated his information on August the 18th, 2018, which was probably 20 days later. But that's when they wrote this letter. But who knows? They probably took, what, 3 or 4 days to receive something from him. By the time they received something from him, then they responded back, you know, probably less than 20 days that he got all his information back. Less than 20 days. But then you have guys telling people that only how you can get your stuff back is if you pay. What type of nonsense is that? And then people actually believe that. He want people to believe that in order for people who come to me who got assistance, they made an agreement to get their license back. Now, why would they donate to me or give me a gift only for me to tell them to agree with them? What type of nonsense does that make? Who would pay their money to be told that? No one. Obviously, they already tried that before they come to me. You know, it's not rocket science. Obviously, they already tried this stuff. Then they come to me and then they get what they need. Okay? And get understanding. But let's continue. It states the date of this notice, 8/18/2018. So he received this. This notice was created probably no more than like 15, 16 days after they probably received information from Dez. But let's continue. I crossed out my occupant information. Reference number crossed out. Person ID crossed out. Date of birth crossed out. FSR count number crossed out. Court order number crossed out. Then it says, read this notice. Hold on, let me zoom out. It states, read this notice. It explains the status of your suspension of hunting and fishing license. This notice is to inform you that because you have come into compliance on the child support order listed above, the association suspension of your hunting and fishing license has been lifted for that order only. Well, he only has one order anyway, so it doesn't matter. But you notice, they always say that they have come into compliance, but they never tell you what they did to come into compliance. It never states that, well, we received your payment of $1,000 in full. You are now in compliance. It never states that. And it never states that, well, you sent me a doc. We received your letter dated so-and-so of you agreeing to pay us $400 a month for the next 6 months. So now you are in compliance. It never states that. It just states that they are in compliance miraculously. They never tell you how they became in compliance. But all of a sudden, a month later, from everybody that does it, they receive a letter of being back in compliance again. How is that possible, man? You see? But you have haters out there that's going to hate. And I love the hate, man. Because the hate just make me work harder and harder and harder and put more and more information out there, more and more truth. And it also make me want to help guys out even more to get that remedy so we can throw it in their face more and more and more and more and more. I mean, it's getting bad for guys so bad, man. They run into emails trying to get somebody to vouch for them before they can try to say that their stuff working. We're not using emails, man. We're using actual documents from the agency or from the court. Actual documents, man. No emails. But let's continue. It states, until the date of your original suspension period is reached, your hunting and fishing license will remain suspended. At that time, if you are compliant with all child support orders, you will be sent a notice of compliance, which restores your right to apply for hunting and fishing licenses again. If you have questions about this notice, contact your child support technician. So again, they are pointing you in the direction if you have any type of questions or problems, who to handle it with. It don't say if you have any problems or any questions, then go down to the court and file your documents. No, it don't state that. You must handle your problems with your brother first before you bring him to the court. And then if they don't listen, you bring them before the court, and the court will hand them to the bailiff, and the bailiff will put them in jail. Same thing the child support agency is doing. They're coming to you, telling you how much you owe. You're not responding back. You're not doing anything. Next thing you know, you end up in court. Next thing you know, they're handing you over to the bailiff, and then they're throwing you in jail. The same thing. The whole goal of the whole thing is to stay in honor. That's it. That's all. You know, contracts, contracts, contracts. You know, if you believe there are other ways to get out, okay, do it. But until then, this is the way I know and I've seen work. And that's all I'm doing is showing people what I know and what I've seen work for people. Okay? So now, if anybody else can provide proof that any other way work, okay, I'll be glad to see it. And then maybe we can all go that way. That's what I'm saying. But until I see tangible documents and tangible evidence saying that people are seeking some type of remedy, be as though getting money back, be as though getting their job license reinstated, be as though getting their hunt license reinstated, be as though getting their cases dismissed and vacated and all types of other stuff, that's the documents that I've been showing. That's why I'm sticking to the same way I've been going until I see anything different. And nobody haven't showed that yet. But let's continue. It states, to avoid future suspensions of your hunting and fishing privileges, you must remain in compliance with all child support orders. CC, Department of Natural Resources, Division of Parks and Wildlife. So again, with the state enforcement signature name on there. So again, we're keeping it 100. We're keeping things moving. We're not playing games, you know. For all my brothers out there fighting, continue to fight. If you all need my help, hit me up in my email at yallismagnified@gmail.com. But that's all I'm going to do for today. Again, more facts, more truth, more proof, more evidence. You know, we're moving over here. The more brothers I help, the more results I'm showing. Okay? Don't let the haters convince y'all to try to discredit the truth. The truth cannot be discredited. The truth will only show itself more. And again, all glory and honor to the Most High Yah, because Yah, He will be magnified. It's not me, it's Him. All glory and honor go to the Most High Yah, Yahuwah Elohim of Israel. That's who it goes to. So with that being said, you all be blessed again. Shalom.